Obviously, today's episode has a very, very special guest, and this is more to do with what's up with women cricket. And we find out from one of the best going around right now, one of the most elegant batters going around in world cricket, I can say. The other day, I was chatting to Virat also. We were watching a game of yours going on TV that day of the 100. Smriti, thank you so much for doing this. And how's it going, by the way? You played a test match at Bristol. We were watching the game. How's it going? How was it playing test cricket for after a long, long time?
Well, yeah, I think the test match, first of all, thank you for having me. And yeah, the test match was a really cool experience, especially playing it after almost 7 years. I think I made my test debut in 2014, and then we didn't play any test cricket 7-8 years. But I still remember, I think we have played World Cup finals and all, but I think still that test match, first test match, is still fresh in my memories. So you also know how incredible it is to wear those whites and just go out there and to play test cricket. So yeah, I think the test match was fantastic, and I think 4 days were not enough to get a result that shows that how good that both the teams played actually. So nowadays we see 4 days is almost enough to get a result in England. But yeah, I think it was an amazing experience to be a part of the test match.
So anyway, I mean, I would have asked that question any which ways. Thanks for leading me on. So there was a lot of debate at the end of the test match whether women cricket should have the fifth day. Whether, I mean, obviously in those times where test match cricket was first incepted, if you take back long, long ago, they just assumed that 4 days will be enough for the girls, right? And do you see a space where the fifth day will help, or do you think test matches will get results in 4 days? What are your thoughts around it?
Well, actually, it really depends a lot on the wicket, definitely. The wicket was very different in Bristol, but definitely a 5 day test match also will be a very good experience. But for now, I would just love to play as much as test cricket. 4 days, 5 days, whatever it is, as much as test cricket would be great for women's cricket. That's my feeling. I think to start with, we can see how next 2 years goes with 4 days cricket, and definitely if we feel that we are not getting the results, we can definitely add the fifth day. But for that, we need to play test matches at a regular interval.
Right, that's precisely the next question. You made a brief emphasis on why test match cricket could be very important for women cricket, and I can see, right, I've been traveling around the world, I watched the Big Bash, you play in the Big Bash yourself, you played in that blast of sort of thing which has been scrapped now, it's the 100 now. So when you look at the health of international women cricket, say include South Africa, West Indies, then you've got India, Australia, England, New Zealand, it is growing, isn't it? And does test cricket make the quality of women cricket better? Or why do you say that it needs to happen?
Well, definitely, I think where women's cricket was probably 8-10 years back, we just had top three teams, England, New Zealand, Australia, doing, you know, getting through the semis and finals all the time. But now we see South Africa coming through. India is doing quite well for last 4-5 years. And definitely, I think, as I think I've seen a lot of interviews on Sky Cricket of Virat, and I've seen Rohit's interview, and everyone so says that whatever, even if the audience comes for one-day cricket or T20 cricket, but as players, to play test cricket is special. And I think that's the same for women's cricket, because I think test cricket tests you with the mental, I think it needs a lot of mental preparations. And I think that can definitely help in one-days and T20s as well. So I feel in that way, three formats in women's cricket would be great going forward.
Okay, three formats in women cricket. All right, I hear you loud and clear. But we can easily call you a globetrotter from India. I mean, as players in the men's arena, we don't get to travel around the world and play in the Blast or the 100 or the Big Bash, but it does look amazing from the outset. But what about you girls going and playing? I mean, especially you, Deepthi Sharma, Harmanpreet Kaur, you know, now Shefali Verma in the mix. All of you all get to play around the world. And what is there any cultural difference at all amongst how cricket is viewed elsewhere and how it's viewed in India for the girls?
Yeah, definitely. I think it's a massive culture difference when you come to the different team, different setups. First of all, you're out of your comfort zone. Like when you're part of a team, like I'm playing for India for last 7 years, so that dressing room is my comfort zone. Once you leave that comfort zone and come into a different team, and you have to start the conversation. It's not, they don't think of you of anything. It's just, everyone is as equal as everyone is. So you have to restart the conversation. You have to build the team. You have to, like, get going. I think that's a very good experience for everyone. Like even when I come here, I literally forget what has happened in international cricket. It's a new start for like 1 month. It's like I have to build a name for myself for the next 1 month, because what they're gonna see is gonna be what they're gonna think of me. They're not gonna really, of course, they will know who I am as a player, but otherwise they're gonna just rely on the performances. So yeah, I think in those things the experience is amazing. And I wouldn't say cultural shift in the way they look at cricket. Cricket is, I would say, isn't definitely, the preparations is a lot different than what we do in Indian team. Preparations here is completely different. Their skill work, their fitness levels are, the way they go about their fitness and skills is slightly, I would say, has a massive difference.
Well, that's interesting. So you actually think preparation and stuff is completely different away from India, is it? Do the Aussies or the English women train any better than what we do back home? Or just that they have a larger pool of players?
I would just say that it's different, that their focus is more on fitness, and then second comes skill. For India, we know as Indians that we first think about skills, and then the second thing is fitness. So here you'll have less practice sessions, less net sessions, but gym sessions and running sessions will be literally every day. So in India, we might not have a gym session or a running session, but we'll definitely have a net session. So that way, that preparation is slightly more different. And of course, the way you approach the match is different in all the teams. Even in India, like all the domestic teams approach it differently. But yeah, I feel that is a massive difference in the way they look at skills and fitness as a separate, and probably focus more on fitness than skills even before a match. Before a match, how we are as Indians, we want to be we have to time the ball really well.
It's interesting that you say that things are perceived differently, especially when it comes to the women cricket in India and away from it. So what I've always wanted to know was, do the girls watch all of the men's matches? Do they follow it to the T, or how does it work? Do you guys, do you people follow international men's cricket, or how does it work?
Well, I am not much of a cricket watcher. I do watch a lot of test matches. I love watching India play test matches. That's something I love, like watching Anderson bowl to you guys is like, I just love watching that battle out there. So definitely I watch that a lot more, but I wouldn't say that, like again with women's cricketers, some people love watching cricket, so they can watch anything on TV, whichever cricket is going on, men's, women's, anything is on, they will watch it. But for me, I'm not much like, I will, once I come off practice, I just feel again, if I'm playing cricket, it's like a lot too much for me. So but yeah, definitely the important matches I don't miss out on, and definitely test matches I think I watch all of them, most of them. Or even if I didn't get to watch the match, I definitely come back to the room and catch the highlights.
That's interesting, because you said a lot of other girls love watching cricket. So is there something inside your heart deep down that feels, okay, it'll be nice if the men also followed the women's cricket? Is there something that lies down? Does that get discussed ever in the dressing room? Will that really motivate the girls more, that every lot more people are following, the men's cricket team also follows what the women cricket team does? Would that make a difference?
We definitely didn't think about it that, you know, do men watch or no? Like it's I have not had a thought actually. But see, for women's cricket, as many people watch it at the moment, whoever new audience we get, it's amazing for the sport, amazing for the development of women's cricket. And I think men's cricket has helped women's cricket to evolve where it is. It's not like it's always good to get support of men cricketers to start up with. Like, we used to have double headers initially. Now we play single matches, women matches, still we get a lot of crowd. Initially, to start up with, we had to play double headers to get that sort of crowd for women's cricket. So yeah, I think if men support, it would be cool, but really haven't given a thought about it.
Yes. The reason why I asked that was about the crowds. Even when I asked initially about the culture, about how different countries view women cricket. Even now when I'm watching the 100 ball, right, there are a certain amount of audience who turn up for the watching the girls. Even in the recently concluded series where you played South Africa in Surat, you were playing full houses, right? And it must make a difference, like people following the girls around, giving the sort of support that might really, you know, take the atmosphere one notch higher. How does it feel? Is it culturally different in India? Yes, Surat had amazing crowds, but do you feel predominantly you get better crowds when you play away from India for the girls' games?
I wouldn't say not recently. I think we have got good crowds in India whenever we have played in India home series, and when it is like out there, people know that we are playing. They have always turned up for the T20 challenges which we have been part of,
yes.
Or I think the series which we have been playing. So I think crowds in India, I would say for women's cricket has been bigger than we have played outside India for last 3-4 years. But yeah, it's always good to play in front of crowd. Like, I think you guys would have, you guys played a lot in the empty stadium now because of the COVID. So, you know, like with the crowd and without the crowd, it's a completely different picture when you're fielding out there or you're batting out there. So, so definitely, I think more the crowd, more the people watching women's cricket and following, I think that's amazing for the game. And I think the way where we have reached, it's going to just keep taking it forward.
The reason why I asked about crowds was because of the recently concluded World Cup final at the MCG. You girls had a turnout of probably 80,000 plus, and that's a record turnout for a crowd for a women's game. And I was just, you know, blown away to say the least, because in fact I was invited over for that game to come and watch that game, but we were on transit, so I couldn't come and watch the game. But looking at it from the outside and the number of people that turned up. And sometimes, you know, sometimes when I watch the girls, I mean, when you girls were playing in Bangalore, was it Bangalore? I can't remember exactly from the top of my head, where a New Zealand team had toured India and we probably filled up about 4,000, 5,000 people. But whereas if I look at the 100, every single franchisee has loyal fans. I mean, I don't know about the Big Bash. Is it any different in the Big Bash?
The games are completely at a different place where the men's Big Bash is happening. It definitely doesn't on the same ground. So... But yeah, I think women's Big Bash also have a good crowd, especially for the semis and finals. We get a very good crowd. And yeah, I think crowds for the 100 have been really amazing. I really didn't expect, because I remember playing KSL, which was their T20 format before 100. Kia Super League, it was called, I guess. Yeah. And not many people, I think, only for the finals, they would turn out. But here, each and every game, we have 10,000 plus crowds, which is amazing to be part of. And just to be part of that match where so many people are turning out to watch.
The reason why I asked about franchise cricket is a direct extension, right? So you have the Women's Big Bash. You have the 100 now. Before, you said it was the Kia Super League, which was the direct, you know, opposite for the T20 Blast for the girls. You've been playing the women's T20 challenge in the IPL, where you get three teams, the Supernovas and all that. And I was watching that game in Sharjah last year, and I found, yeah, it was amazing. It was pretty cool to watch. So is there enough depth, you think, in women's cricket to have a women's IPL at this stage? Does India have so many players to fill up 7 into 8 sides or 6 sides? What are your thoughts around it?
Well, definitely, I think there are same number of states which play for men and women. So when they started men's IPL, there were same number of states. But of course, the quality went higher and higher as the years passed by. Like what IPL is today, IPL 10 years back or 11 years back wasn't the same. So I think same with women's cricket. We have same amount of girls playing cricket. We have the same amount of states, like the state level cricket is the same. So, but I think for now we will have a good 5 or 6 teams to start with, and probably in a year or two. But if till we don't start, we don't know. Like we can't always like have this conversation that is there any depth or no. We have never had a competition in women's cricket which is 6 team, like a T20 tournament. So we don't know if we have or no. So how can we just judge and say that we don't have?
I'm 100% sure that it will be an amazing hit. I am one of the ardent followers of women's cricket, and I know for a fact that there are a lot of cricketers who play. In fact, I'm so sad that Railways win the competition every year. You know, they have most of the players playing for them and they win it every year. So I actually try and see whether anybody else is coming up from any other state. So I'm a big supporter, and that's why I asked you if there is enough depth, because you're the one that
That's what I'm saying. Like 5-6 teams, I would say we are good to go with. But definitely 8 teams, I'm still not sure if what it looks like. But I think we need to really start with 5 or 6 teams so that we actually get to 8 teams very soon. And I think till we don't start, we are not really giving the exposure to the girls to actually turn their cricket into a really different level. Because I have been part of Big Bash for like four years back I played, and the quality now is completely different. And you can see that in Cricket Australia, the team, they have like 40-50 players ready to play international cricket any day. So I really want that to happen to Indian cricket, and I think IPL will play a huge role in that.
Women's IPL will be so nice, right? And I'm looking forward to it too. But finally, before I let you go, I have a few questions, very small questions to ask. And you've been playing. I said you're a globetrotter of the game.
That's a big word.
It is a globetrotter. I mean, you are a globetrotter from... I mean, you girls will probably be the, you know, first, you know... Sort. I went to Lords today and I was seeing there are pictures of teams that travel to England from the 18th century, you know.
Okay.
Likewise, if we go back in Indian history, any stage and ask, who are the first globetrotters of Indian sport, Indian cricket? You girls will probably be at the top of it. So I have no doubts about it. But the question I wanted to ask you is friendships, you know, cross-cultural friendships that you make with Aussies, with the Kiwis, with the, you know, the English and South Africans and so far. How many such friendships have you made, and who's your best friend on some of these trips?
Well, I think we have definitely had a very good bond with all the girls, especially I think English. I have played last 3 years. I've come here to England and been playing. So, but I would say, yeah, Heather Knight is a good friend. Anya Shrapsole, now she's a captain. Yes, we all get along well. So there are a few. Sophie Eccleston, she comes down to T20 Challenge and she's always in my team. So that's, we have also gotten along well. Yeah, and Aussies, I think where I played Hobart, they didn't have many Australian players. So yeah, other than that, here and there, but definitely once you play as an opposition, you just talk for that tournament, and then it's like not that you will constantly be in touch, but definitely these 3-4 people are, now Danny White is in my team, so she's also become good friend, yeah.
You open the batting with her, don't you? So I saw you both bat.
Yeah.
It's nice to watch. One of them sweeping and the other one going down the ground. Pretty, that's a pretty sight to watch. Anyway, moving on. I'd like to ask a very brief question. I'm not going to take you back to your childhood. So I run an academy myself. I mean, we have been running it for about 10 years now. And there is this constant search from parents about whether my girl will be safe going and playing amongst boys in an academy. Will she be safe? Is it a girl's sport? And all these are questions that still exist as we are talking in 2021. Okay. And what is your take, and how did your parents cope with it, and how should the parents of girls go about it?
Well, I think my parents were really, I would say, really forward thinking even when I started. Probably, when did I start? When I was 5. I am 25 now, so 20 years back. So my parents were literally, they never, like initially when I was a kid, of course, dad used to come with me for practice. He was the one who started teaching me. But to be frank, when I started, I used to actually be around 100 boys in the academy, and I never felt unsafe. I literally never felt. I was always treated like a special person because I was the only girl in 100 boys, and I used to get more batting. So yeah, definitely. I think if you really want a girl to play, and if you really want to take that effort, probably go for a year and see, go accompany her with the practice. But I'm sure it's not like it's unsafe or anything. It's pretty safe out there, and it's a women's sport. It's a girl's sport. Like I think it's high time everyone understands that every sport is a men and women's sport, and a girls and boys sport.
Right. That's amazing to hear from you, because recently I went to one of our academy games. Whenever I find time in Chennai, I go and watch. Not recently, before pre-COVID times, let me say. And there was one girl who was playing on both. And either side, there was just one girl representing one of those teams. She was actually playing against our academy. And she, at the end of the game, won the player of the match. And I was so amazed to say, okay, it's amazing to see a girl. And saw her parents and they were talking to her. And then I realized, why don't more girls turn up for such games? Because at a young age of 10, 12 and 14, if they can compete with boys, they can get so much better in their, you know, cricket or whatever it is. I just really wish that more girls took up the sport. And if I said that, it wouldn't make a difference. So your message for young girls to take up the sport?
Well, I just feel that at the moment, cricket is growing, especially women's cricket. And as a girl, my experience is it's an amazing game, and it's a very very special feeling to wear the India jersey and go out there to bat and represent India in all formats. So if you want to feel the same and you want to represent India and feel that pride, I think you should really start playing. I wouldn't say like come play cricket, play any sport, but I think it's just amazing atmosphere at the where the world is heading to, women's sport and girls cricket or women's cricket, where the world is heading to. So I said it, I feel it's the right time to just pick up a bat or ball and start playing cricket.
So far, so good. We've been very pro Smriti Mandhana, but I'm going to ask you, who's been the toughest bowler that you faced? You seem to enjoy batters. You enjoy the battle James Anderson throws to different batters. But now, which bowler has troubled you in world cricket so far? Or let's just say, which bowler is someone that you found it tough to play against?
Well, I think Juludi is always tough to face in nets. She always turns up with that fiery aggression which she has. She doesn't want, if I play one shot to her, she will be fuming at me. So, always a scary fast bowler who is angry is always, you're always scared, like they're very tough to bat to. So I would say Juludi in nets because I haven't played against her much. And Maryzen Capp, she's from South Africa. She bowls, she's she hits
Did she
a
bowl
very
the
hard
first
net.
over of the 100? She bowled the
Yeah,
first over of the 100.
she
She
was
bowled
she
the full set
bowled,
of 10.
yeah, she bowled the
That's amazing.
first two. I think she took the first ever wicket of 100 as well, I guess.
Yes, she did. Yeah, caught
Yeah,
behind, I think. Caught
caught
behind net.
behind, yes, right.
She bowled the first set of 10 as well. That also goes down in the history, you know, because
Yeah.
that game was played before the men's game. So it is the time for the women. And I really wish a women's IPL happens. Sorry, a women IPL happens. And I look forward to it. All the very best, Smriti, and look forward to your
Yes.
career. And hope you get many more test games and you make a lot of fun.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much for this.